words of encouragement to you. I'm a little nervous, so bear with me. Sometimes you have to encourage yourself. Sometimes you have to speak victory during the test. And no matter how you feel, speak the words that you would be healed. Speak over yourself, encourage yourself in the Lord. Oh, 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 oh. Sometimes you have to speak a word over yourself. Depression. Encourage yourself in
the Lord. Dr. Green, needless to say, this has been a very trying week at school. What's it like when you have such a terrible tragedy? A 16-year-old boy dies suddenly. What's the impact on your school?
There are two impacts. One is we all get it as a family. What do you ask? All pathways.
The Long Beach School District, that they really help out the family in that crisis. It's happened on Thursday. It's happened to that.
Robinson,
how do you describe something like this? Such a young man is taken from us so early.
Well, you can't describe something like this. Something like this is fatal to the community. It's the heart of the community. This young man was in the prime of his life, and he just was a wonderful light to the community. And I think that it's a shock that this young man has passed away.
Talk about how the MLK Center came together with the high school and the Long Beach community to put together such a moving tribute to this young man.
Well, I think the MLK has done a wonderful job blending together with the community blending with the MLK. All hands on deck when things like this happen. We just a wonderful delight how the community has responded to this young man's death and embracing all of the children's needs in the community, which I think is a great tribute to this young man.
Talk about the MLK Center, the way it helps the youth in the community.
Well, just like Dr. King envisioned his life to like all embrace all men and to embrace all nationalities. That's what the MLK does to each community. It embraces everybody and have everybody feelings and all the emotions that the MLK produces. It's a wonderful thing, especially for the young people. Young people come here, they feel free, they feel to express their feelings and to make a better way for democracy. And I think that's what Dr. King envisioned for the world
but many Long Island championships still be
done.
This tragedy hits home for you because you knew Shaquille Moore personally. Talk about this young man.
I coached his cousins, and they all lived in the same house on Woods Avenue in best memories of little Fred is called by the family and Puff, their other little brother, when we would drop them off at night, how happy they were to see them. And Fred was very quiet.
You'll be good tomorrow, right?
I see he grew into a nice young man. Just heartbroken for the family. He's tragic.
Joe, you're reliving this again because his cousin Dante Barron played for you and he died of a heart problem in his early 20s. So this is home a second time. This poor family's going through it again, losing a second young man.
That's what I said. His sister, Wanda and Nicole, are sisters, and now they both lost young men to a heart problem. It's just a tragic.
Have you ever been in love, so bad? You would do anything to make them understand? Have you ever had someone to steal your heart away? To give anything to make them feel the same. Have you ever had the words to get you in your heart, but you don't know what to say and you don't know where to start? Have you ever loved somebody so much it makes you cry? Have you ever needed something so bad you can't sleep at night? Have you ever tried to find the words but they don't come out right? Have you ever?
I gave you my heart since day one without even knowing it. I love you with all of me unconditionally. As you grew up, we grew close. You grew not to only be my brother, but my best friend. Yeah, we fought at times, but you always stood up for me. I miss everything about you, from the night you would climb through the window when you was late at night, your loud music playing through the night, the times you would come in my room just to get lotion. I even miss the time I'd say, Fred, can you take out the garbage? You were, and you still are, till this day, a very wonderful brother, uncle, cousin, and friend. We all here to say, not only sorry that you had to leave us, but we will always, forever and ever miss you. You will stay in each and every one of our hearts, and you will never be forgotten. And we will never forget the famous word that you always will say. May you rest in paradise, and we all love and miss you.
Thank you, Mr. Varsity basketball coach. I did speak to a lot of you Saturday night at the vigil, which was wonderful. I just first want to say, my sincere condolences to the family. You are one very courageous family. You're incredible people. You guys have been showing so much strength
And I want to give you my sincere condolences from all of us at the high school, and especially on the basketball team. As far as the friends of Shakur, you guys have been extremely supportive as well. You know, it makes me so proud to hear that some of you guys have gone over to the family's house and spent some time with them to support them as well. I just want you guys to know that, you know, this is a very difficult time for the family, but it's going to, of course, be much more difficult, especially after Thursday and Friday this week. So I just ask you guys to continue the support and continue to show up for Shakur's family and be there for them after kind of the dust settles from here. As far as Shakur goes, you know, the strength that I mentioned that the family has is clearly visible through Shakur. Now I see where he had gotten that from. And, you know, he was a great teammate. He would do anything for the team. You know, I gave a quick story the other day that I think I want to share with some of you that didn't hear it the other night. But during one of our practices, our tryout at the beginning of the season, this was last year, when Shakur tried out, some of the other teammates had tried out, we were running, you know, lines, and some of the players didn't get across the line within 30 seconds. So about five players had to run those lines again to beat that time under 30 seconds. And I asked across the court, about 40 players, you know, does anybody want to step up and be a good teammate and step up on the line and run with these other five guys and show support? And one guy stepped up to show support, and that was Shakur. You know, that just goes to show his character, his courage, and he's just a wonderful, wonderful kid that we're certainly going to miss. God bless him, and God bless the family.
God took him to his loving home. He saw him getting tired. He curled what was not to be. He wrapped him up in his loving arms and whispered, "Come with me." He suffered much in silence. His spirit did not bend. He faced his pain with courage until the very end. He tried so hard to stay with us, but his fight was not in vain. God took him to a loving home and freed him from his pain. "You will not see me, so you must have faith. I wait for the time when he can soar together again, both aware of each other. Until then, live your life to its fullest, and when you need me, just whisper my name in your heart. I will be there. Rest in peace, Shakur Moore. We love
you." And why should the shadows call? Why should my heart feel lonely, alone for my heaven and home? When Jesus is my portion, a constant friend is he. His eyes on the sparrow, and I know that Fred is watching over us. I say, because I'm happy, and I say, because I am yet free. His eyes on the spirit, and I know Fred is watching over us. watches. I know Fred is watching. Always.
Death is nothing at all. I have only slipped away to the next room. I am I, and you are you. Whatever we were to each other, that we still are. Call me by my old familiar name. Speak to me in the easy way which you use. Put no difference in your tone. Wear no forced air of sorrow. Laugh as we always laugh at the little jokes we enjoy together. Play, smile, think of me, pray for me. Let my name be ever the household word that it always was. Let it be spoken without effect, without the trace of a shadow in it. Life means all that it ever meant. It is the same that it ever was. This is absolute unbroken continuity. Why should I be out of mind because I am out of sight? I am but waiting for you, for an interval, somewhere, very near, just around the corner. All is love.
It's very hard to stand here. Typically we're here for happy and joyous occasions, but nonetheless, this is a happy and joyous occasion because we're celebrating the life of someone who loved life and who lived it fully. And it's just sad, it saddens us all here, the MLK family, to lose anyone, and especially one of our youth. So it means so much to be able to see all the faces here tonight and the support of the Long Beach community. I can't even begin to tell you of the phone calls that we have received and the support that we received from everyone, from the city manager's office all the way down. Ms. Cutler has been wonderful. Dr. Greenberg, thank you so much for allowing all of the staff to do what they've done for us here at the MLK. I know on behalf of myself and the board, we appreciate every kind word, every good wish, and every prayer that has been sent our way. We're saddened just as the family is, but nonetheless, we know that God knew best, and we don't have answers for all that has happened, but we're able to stand here today and rejoice and be happy that all of us are showing love and support for one another. So again, thank you all tonight for being here, and if there's anything else that the MLK can do, anything that I can do, always know that we're here for you. And
I just want to say to the family, to Nicole, and the siblings, the cousins, relatives, everybody, that, you know, this is a loss that we are all suffering with you. You know, this happened right here in this very building, you know, in our hometown. So it pains all of us. There's a lot of children here that barely comprehend the whole concept of life, and now they're forced to have to try to understand death. You know, and they're taking this to bed with them. They're waking up every day and they're remembering something that's paining them. And as a community, you know, we're all feeling this. What I want to say to all the children, the family, all of you all, is that life is something that we live even when we can't see it. You know, I once said that energy, life is like energy which can never be destroyed, only changed and altered in this form. So even though we can't see that, whenever your children get together, the family gets together, when you remember those memories and you celebrate those good times, those sayings, those things that he said and he done that make you feel good, you make him relive through those moments and relive in you. You activate those thoughts and you bring him back into existence. I remember the first time when I was a little bit younger and I used to do music. And I was very close with one of my partners in my group. We traveled all throughout this country doing shows. And coming up young, you think you're just indestructible. You know, as children, we really don't understand the concept of death or appreciating life to the point where we can't imagine people close to us being gone. And when my younger partner had passed, that was a reality to me that, you know, we really can lose one another. You know, and that was very hard for me to deal with. You know, there was no counselors, really nobody to talk to. That's something I had to just eat. You know, but it's like as time went on, you know, my partner, he's still here with me to this day. Because there's a lot of things that I do that I find funny, that I laugh at, and I know that he'll crack up as well. And I'll hear him in my mind still, you know. So those are the things that I hold on to. But I have to say to this community of Long Beach, you know, we've had some tragedies, we've gone through things, but we're going to make it through this one, and we're going to support this family and show them our love. We're going to embrace this. And for the MLK Center, you know, I also want to give you guys, you know, wish you all strength, because there's a lot of things that you had to accept that's happening right here in this building, and everybody probably feel like there's more they could have done to probably have stopped that, you know, but when a person's time comes, that's just their time. There's not much you can do about that. And you can live a whole lifetime, you know, to achieve a certain goal. But when it's your time, it's your time. You know, and that's just what it is. And, you know, to the family, I just say that I love you all. You know, I don't think the same, but I want to up here to be a symbol of just that love and the impact. You know, my sons, they was at home. They felt the way about it, you know. They were very upset, very disappointed, and all these kids had that same impact. So as a community, you know, he lives through each and every one of us. The more that we fellowship and we celebrate him, we allow him to relive through us. So with that being said, I just love you all, you know, and the rest of the community, that's his whole type of the family. All right, thank you.
That day, when he passed away, me and Miles the whole day, you know, just playing Xbox, chilling. For some reason, he was happy, though. He always had a smile on his face the whole day. So, I'm just mad he's gone. That was my boy. I'm gonna miss him.
Hi, everybody. Yeah, Shakur's my best friend to everybody that know me. I know all y'all always send me and to him every day. We always be at his house. As soon as you knock, Nicole be like, oh my God, would y'all just go home already? She did it all the time. We was just sit there and laugh. And Shakur just laughed at I don't know. I'm not a public speaker. I don't got that much to say. But I love Shakur, and he always in my heart.
I just wanted to say again that I did not know him, but just looking out at everyone that's here, I think that Shakur's name means love. His name means unity. You know, he was somebody special in the community, and I can tell that he was special to each and every one of us because everybody's here representing. And I can see him now with it, you know, just smiling and like, yeah, all this love here. You know, and I just thank God for being able to have a memory of him. I thank you, Shakur's mom. I thank you for having him, you know, because if you hadn't had him, then I wouldn't feel how I'm feeling right now. And I thank you too, sister, his sister. I thank you. And I feel like you guys, even though he's not here, just looking at you guys, I still see him. Just be encouraged.
What I want to say is that I'm really going to miss Shakur and that I love him. And I'm always going to remember the last thing he said to me, which was, D.H. Moore, don't touch my crotch, Busta. And we shared a lot of memories with him. And I'm just going to miss him. My name's Rhea, if y'all don't know me. But I was really close with Fred, and one of the things I really liked to do was text Fred, because in person he didn't really speak that much. But like when he was around all of us and the boys or whatever, he was himself, and he always spoke and joked around us and everything. Like he'd joke around everyone else, but he wasn't really himself. I can say that we had a lot in common. We both liked the Celtics. And we both went to Pittsburgh to win the Super Bowl, which they are. And I don't know, I'm really gonna miss Fred a lot. He was really like a brother to me. And yeah, I'm gonna miss him a lot. And I love all y'all. And I'm here if you all need me. Okay? Hi everyone. I'm Regina, of course. Y'all probably know me. I'm loud enough. But anyway, Fred was just like a really good person. Every time he stepped in the room, I was always like, oh, there go Fred. Or I'd be like, Fred, why are you coming to school? Nah, chill. I ain't feel like going today. And we'll always go back and forth. But every time Fred came in the cafeteria, it was like this light. Like he'll always make us all happy. And every time he was there, we'll have something to talk about and everything. But I mean, we know he's in a better place, and he's looking down on all of us. And to the family, y'all know I love you guys. Like y'all my family. And yeah. So.
my name is Natalie. I'm gonna really miss Shakur. He was a very kind person. He was sweet. He always took off what he had on his back to make sure you had something. Or like if it was cold, he gave you his jacket or whatever. He just always made sure you had something. I'm gonna really miss him. Rest in peace, Shakur. I love you.
Hi everyone, I'm Sierra. Hi Nicole! Wow, I can't believe Shakur is gone. I'm gonna miss him so, so much. I'm gonna do this thing without him. Happy Shakur.
Shakur, that was my boy right there. I remember when me, him, Bubba, and all of them had that fight in the house. And then him and Bubby jumped me. But me and Alan got them all back. I'm gonna miss him having fights with him and him always talking junk to me.
Give them all a round of applause.
Really don't know what to say. Like, he's my favorite brother, and well, other than Bubba. Speechless. Like, it really hurts to see my brother gone. I don't know.
I remember when I first met him, it was in here, and I think I was like the first person to walk up to him and ask him if he wanted to play. And I had to ask him like 5 times what was his name, because he just didn't talk. And
me and Shakur, we weren't the best of friends, but we were close. I mean, I remember when I did meet him, he was probably in here playing basketball. He was probably one of the most people that were like full of energy, always up and down the court. First person down the court, the ball go up. I remember always seeing him around, always had a smile on his face, always had made people laugh. You know, me and him had a little handshake thing when we see each other. Take it back to the night everything happened. I just remember seeing his eyes open. I'm pretty sure he's seen all of us around here trying to help him out, trying to do everything we can for him. But there probably wasn't much we could do, because like Alonzo said, and like I learned from my mother, when God comes, he comes. Rather, you ready, he's coming for you. And that's really it. You just gotta live with it and try to just remember him as best way as you can. But he's probably here with us right now, just watching all of us. You never know. And if he is, I'm saying we do want you to know we miss you and love you. Hope you rest easy and we'll see you soon.
Someone spoke about our family earlier. About us being strong. This is not the first time we went through something like this. One thing I can say, we may not always get along, but our family, no matter what, we're always there for each other. And Nicole, I want you to know I love you. And no matter what you need, even though I don't have a lot to give, I'll always be there for you. And I don't really wish to put anybody on the spot, but I wanted to invite Coach Joe Vito to come and say something, because he's been with our family throughout many tragedies. And he's known Fred as well, so you can just come up and say something.
Feel better, and I know you're feeling better, because I see you with a red nose. And, like, it's really harsh that he had to die, but to stay strong.
If we want to discuss bubbles, I met Fred here in front of
center with James one day, and I met this little kid who had some real swag to him, and he called me OG Mac. I didn't quite understand the OG Mac part. He told me the OG Mac part was because I had the gray in my beard. But what I mean to say here is that when you have life, you have a legacy. And the legacy part is, if you look to the right of you and you look to the left of you, there's people all around. That means you touch people. You don't only touch the youth, you also touch older people, you touch the whole community. And I have two fond memories with this young man. When I first came back into the Long Beach community, I was volunteering with Powerful Hands. I was doing the calisthenics part of the boxing program. So we would come in the gym at night and we would run. So I knew this kid had a lot of energy because I said, well, we're gonna run 60 laps around this gym. I had already ran 30, but he lapped me two times before I could get to the 30. So I know he had a lot of energy, and I wasn't here the night when it happened, but I did meet my buddy James and so many people at the Long Beach Memorial Hospital. And I had another encounter with him. It was quite funny because a lot of people make a lot of jokes behind the back of my neck. I've heard so many things. It looks like a quarter pounder. It looks like steak. It looks like a pack of Franks. Frank came to me one day. I was sitting over by the weights, and I just got to run. I was tired. He touched the back of my neck. He was like, wow, that's a value meal, but it doesn't have the drink with it. I said, oh my God. So he was very funny. He was charismatic. And I got a chance, like I said, I went actually in Christian Light, and I got saved with his mother. And what an honor. I mean, you know, we just, you know, we're really celebrating this kid's life, man. I mean, I was really lost, and I was really moved by, like I said, I never met a young man that has so much swagger. You know what I'm saying? He was just full of life, and he had, like I said, he had so much energy because seeing him run around his gym, he quadruple lapped me, you know what I'm saying? He ran 90 laps by the time I ran 30, so he had a lot of energy. And again, I would like to say thank you so much to the press, to the Herald, to the Patch for really putting out a story. You know what I'm saying? To celebrate this man's life. I know I spoke to Anthony, Chris, I spoke to you, and the staff at the Long Beach High School, MLK Center, James Hart from Miss Stone, and to the family, just be encouraged. You know, there's love all in this building, and we're going to continue to love you and continue to be there for you now and after. And you know that heaven, definitely.
And I would like to share a little poem with you that's titled Miss Me, But Let Me Go by Deborah Staley. When I come to the end of the road and the sun has set for me, I want no rights in a gloom-filled room. Why cry for a soul set free? Miss me a little, but not too long, and not with your head bowed low. Remember the love that we once shared. Miss me, but let me go. For this is a journey that we all must take, and each must go alone. It's all a part of the master's plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick of heart, go to the friends we know, and bury your sorrows in doing good deeds. Miss me, but let me go. When someone you love becomes a memory, the memory becomes a treasure. On behalf of the administrative family at Long Beach High School, Ms. Jessup and family, we would like to present you with a gift, and just remember that our prayers and condolences are with you.
I really cannot say any more than already has been said. We're going to miss Shakur. Thank you.
help your children. Don't let them fall by the side of the road. No, 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 no. Teach them to love one another. That heaven might find a place in the heart. Jesus is love. He won't let you down. I know that he's love, 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 love forever. Truth and his word will be our salvation.